bang, boom.
Welcome to the Nice Guy Radio Podcast. It's your host, Ethan Fiennes, Bench Perkinson.
What? You know, the hell did you just say?
I said things, and things were said by me.
Things? I'm going to have to... Hold up. I need a new spot. Oh, I hit your leg. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
We're just chilling in my basement. Two dudes sitting on a couch, chilling in a basement.
Bridal shower
is going on.
Yes,
above
sir.
Us. That's what's happening right now.
Yeah,
it is. And
we went to space today.
We did go to space.
We told people that we went to space, and we did.
We did it. We unequivocally. Undeniably.
We saw Ryan today too.
Ryan we saw today as of recording today.
A little pizza man.
A little PTSD for him. A little pizza SD.
Yeah.
You can probably hear the vent right now that's not blowing air through it right
it's
now.
It's pretty eventful.
I hate you.
No you don't.
I love you.
Yeah.
So fucking much.
Should we get Fashan in here as a guest?
As a guest?
Let's get him. What's he doing? He's just laughing.
He's just laughing up there. He's cooking, dude.
Alright, am I about to get him?
He's cooking. He's cooking.
Fashan.
He's cooking! Oh my goodness, he's gonna get him. What questions are you going to ask him? Oh no.
Fashan!
Just a couple of dudes. We're live right now, recording a podcast.
Do you consent?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, okay, so, he consents.
So, tell us about you, who you are, and how you're doing today. You can use an alias if you want.
He currently has food in his mouth.
I'm fine. I'm doing as well as any man with a quiche in his mouth.
Okay.
Do you like quiches? You won't tell anybody if you don't like them.
I mean, you're telling whoever you're broadcasting to, so
they aren't listening. It's okay. We'll cut this part. Whether you caught it or not, I guess, sure.
I like quiches, because, as I said, there's one.
As you're winking at us and you're saying, no, I don't like it.
Exactly.
Yeah. We totally didn't see that. Like, yeah. So,
there's no quiches involved in this recording.
No.
No longer. No longer any quiches. I swallowed it.
They gone.
Whole.
Well, I chewed first.
Oh, yeah.
Was it good? Like a good quiche?
I mean, it's about as good as you would get at Big Y, so.
Was it a Big Y quiche?
I believe so.
Right? Okay, all right. Well, that answers that question.
You want to hold your phone?
I'm going to hold my phone, which is recording.
It is
for
recording.
Us today.
So.
It's so cheesy, I can't stand you. I'm trying to keep a straight face.
That brings us to our next question.
Sorry.
So. What's up? You, as a man of many different likes and interests, what's your favorite cheese?
What is my favorite cheese?
This is called Bringing the Cheese with Fashan.
My favorite cheese would have to be Gruyere. It's very delicious. It's very sharp. It has a nutty flavor to it. It's hard when you cut it, but then it has this nice melt in your mouth kind of texture. Unfortunately, because of how it's designed, it's almost designed to be a crumble cheese. So unfortunately, you can't slice it, and that's really annoying. But it's delicious nonetheless.
All right, I like it. Do you have a question for us?
I mean, I was not prepared.
This
is true.
You caught me with a quiche in my mouth. That's the equivalence of being caught with your pants down. You know what I'm saying? You're do you have any questions? Can I pull up my pants now or later? That's all I got.
Well, I mean, we're all dudes. We don't have any pants on. I mean, I literally don't have pants on. You don't have pants on. So I think we're all in the clear.
You guys have shorts.
It's do I have pants?
Well, I mean, they're not pants, are they?
Our pants are not on right now.
Woo! What is the podcast for? I just walked in on this.
I don't know.
You know, it's just a little podcast where we talk about nonsense.
Yep.
Literal nonsense. Every month. Mm-hmm. Once a month.
So once a month, we get together.
Mm-hmm. And we make a nonsense podcast.
Nonsensical podcast.
It's a podcast about nothing.
Practically.
Basically.
That sounds exciting.
What's Seinfeld
wanted to do.
No, I don't think.
That's what he said. He wanted to make a show about nothing, but ended up making a show about something.
Ooh. Okay.
That transitioned us into our sponsor for this half hour.
Well, yep. So we have our sponsor here. It's actually...
who's sponsoring this?
Vishon's Remote Services.
Vishon's Remote Services?
Yeah. So, you know, when you ever have an issue and you're trying to catch something from long range and you're trying to connect, you can't sometimes. So, this guy has a service for you. Do you want to take it away, big guy?
I don't know what that was to describe. Honestly, that was so nonsensical, as is the theme of this podcast, that I myself am... kerfuffled. So,
so use the offer code kerfuffled for 10% your services. That's right. If you go to VishonRemote.com,
kerfuffled is one of those words you learned in like high school, middle school, and you're just like, I need to use this in a sentence. And so, whenever I find the chance to use it, like, this is perfect. I'm so glad.
This is why it's the offer code, dude.
You keep it loose here. I mean, that's what I'm saying.
It's a legit word. You know, it's like 17th century. Like, let's go.
not Bill Clinton. Bill Ben Franklin.
Jesus, wow, that's Christ. Completely different.
Yeah, Bill Clinton was out in the Revolutionary War. No,
they're
about
the same. They're both womanizers, so I mean, pretty good.
Oh, hey.
Whoa. We don't bring politics.
I mean, I got seduced by Ben Franklin.
What does that have to do with politics? I said womanizer. That's not politics. That's personality. Like, have you ever read one of Benjamin Franklin's books? He talked about the greater chance of impregnating a woman was actually making sure that she achieved her orgasm first. He wrote that down. Americans should not use lead, and it is by far the world's most dangerous chemical on this planet. And yet we still tend to put it, we had put it in our gasoline, and it wasn't until the 90s, like 1990s, that we de-lead our gasoline.
Are we just going to skim past the part where Ethan said that he was seduced by Ben Franklin?
Look, I'm not proud of it, but, you know, it was the 1790s. One thing led to another, bada bing, bada boom, you know.
He became the realest guy in the room.
Yeah, I became the realest guy in the room because I was getting Ben Franklin back shots.
Indeed.
That ever happened to you, Ben?
No.
Okay.
No, not usually when your name is also Ben. Does not happen to you.
That's just me.
Okay. I'm safe from that.
Well, I think that'll do it for... Well, actually, no, we have any DMs.
DMs? Oh, yes, DMs. The dead fish DMs. Let me look at my phone upside down for these.
Those are bubbles, by the way. I get, like, bubbly.
See, he does that every time, and then I just end up putting in a sound effect after he does that.
Kind of like a placeholder.
Yeah. And then I just leave him.
So our first DM comes from Benjamin Franklin. It says, Sean, what's going on? Are you selling remotes nowadays?
Am I selling remotes?
Yeah.
Remotes for your remote business.
I mean, nothing certain but death and taxes. Am I right?
So, yes, sir.
Go leave it at that.
Do you want to read the next DM?
All right, cool. This next DM is coming in from Nikola Tesla, who actually is writing in reference to Benjamin Franklin.
Okay.
And he says, hey, Franklin, I'm really curious, you know, people keep talking about that kite and key experiment you did, but that's not what really happened. Can you elaborate on that?
Oh, interesting. Obviously, Ethan, being the resident Benjamin Franklin expert, can't answer the CMs.
We can look at one of his writings that came from a 1793 text called The Art of the Kite. And he does actually mention that the kite incident was never real, and he is also a figment of his own imagination sometimes. So what we can gather from that is, you know, not reading too far into things, but we can see that a lot of what he said was more rhetorical, and maybe the kite is a symbol of American freedom or something idealistic that Benjamin Franklin always thought about. You know, he's always trying to centralize the banks, always trying to...
That was Alexander Hamilton.
Hey, he's also trying to do turn back the clocks for the farmers. He's thinking about the little guy. and the big guy, because he's a hefty dude. He's got a little meat in the cheeks, if you know what I mean.
He was actually quite moderate in size.
Well,
the women loved him.
Yeah, I mean, hey, he's got a little fluff in the trunk and a little junk in the bunk. Oh, hey, that's a hanger there.
Let's not get political now.
That was historically accurate.
That is historically accurate, yeah.
Like, women have written about it.
His penis size.
They have.
Oh my goodness.
His document.
He showed him their founding father.
Oh my goodness.
Imagine you're just getting like an owl delivering
you. Well, can you imagine how good you are that other women wrote like pamphlets of like, yeah, Benjamin Franklin good. Like, you should try him out. Like,
you ever heard
should try him out.
Thomas Paine, more like Benjamin Paine.
No, but like, it's legit. Like, these are history facts. The man was a playboy, had no kids. Don't understand how. I don't understand.
And on top of that, he had servants carry him around in a freaking box cart.
Mm. Well, you got any more DMs you see?
Any more DMs? There is just one. It says hi, and it's from username hi as well.
Block him.
Okay. Done deal.
All right, done deal. That'll do it. Thank you.
I think that will do it. This was going to be, and it always was going to be, our shortest episode ever.
And, yeah. Not
featuring
Toto Optiwo.
Vajon.
Yeah, that also is true. But that was a quote from Dom.
Oh, wait, how long is this one so far?
11 this one is 11 minutes. Seconds.
And yeah. How long are your usual podcast?
45 to an hour.
45 to an hour?
Yeah.
Clean 45.
So there's nothing I can do to stall it and make this not just shortest
no.
one.
No. Probably not.
I was going to mess it up on purpose, but now that I
hey, know. If you got anything in the bag, let the cat out. Air it out.
Throw it over your shoulder and slap it down.
Spank it.
I have blue and orange socks on.
You do. You in fact do.
Indeed,
They got some little green on there, a little blue and orange on there.
Exactly. I figured I was feeling kind of Crayola today, and you know, I used to always be upset with Crayola when I was a kid because every time I wanted to get the skin color crayon, they never had the skin color crayon. They only had peach, and so I would use the peach, thinking that was the same skin color as me. But then one day I was watching Arthur. And then I realized I was black. And it was a very interesting day. Because I was like, oh, I didn't know there was different races at the time. And like, it came in like, just like a vision in the night. You know, like Burning Bush talking to a, you know.
So like, you're like Oppenheimer. You're gaining visions.
Yeah, I gained a vision that I was actually of a different race. I didn't know races exist until, you know, this particular episode of Arthur. Because wow. They were talking about differences, because I thought I was white for like the first 5 years of my life. Anywho,
wow.
Once I realized that, I tried looking for my skin color in the crayon box, and it never came.
Wow.
Sound good.
It never came. They only had Caucasian and peach.
That's oddly specific.
It was a legit crayon box. They took it out because they realized it was racist.
Yeah, that is pretty fucked up.
Can you imagine? Because this is Caucasian, Asian, Negro. It was.
Oh.
And at first, because you know, because to be honest with you, it's the black folk never really actually get offended, bro. We were just happy. It was like, finally, a color that represents us. And then, like, you know, the liberals are all like, oh, that's me. They're offended. I'm over here like, bruh, I need this crayon.
I have so many drawings I need to fill in now. Please. I gotta do some redaction.
Their life stories. Wow. That one's real.
That, wow. I've been enlightened.
No, yeah. You know, most black kids go through that. It's like, by the time they turn about 5 or 6, it's when they realize we don't look like everybody else. Because, you know, there's only, the percentage is 30%. Only 30% of America is other. So, I mean, I'm trying to remember what the exact number is. I think that
might be
exactly. Asians are 2-3%. Hispanics are actually 18%. So that puts African Americans at actually 14%. So America's 14% African American. So it's usually about around ages 5 and 6. Do you recognize? Oh, snap.
Feel free at home to fact check.
Google it.
Do some research.
Legit.
They'll make you smarter.
And then like 0.08, and then like 0.8% is Native American.
It is true.
There are more Asians than Native Americans.
All right. Well.
Well, will that do it?
I think that might. You got anything else?
I mean, unless
you bench? Sure? Because I read a lot of books.
Well, I think we should get back up there. We should do some FaceTime because I hear some kebabbery over there.
Bro, all I was doing was washing dishes. I'm done for the day.
You can wash dishes all together. Big
just everybody just gang up and wash dishes.
Yeah, well, I'll do it. Splish, splash, mean, wish, whack. We're nice.
Dude, am I still required to be here?
No, I think you're good.
Nah, it's the end of the podcast.
We gotta get up there, I think.
Do we?
Yeah, we should.
For what?
I don't know. Let's get some sunlight. What's the purpose? Get some sunlight. You know.
There's sunlight right there.
Dude, that is not
sunlight. We are in the basement. That is sunlight.
That's called the basement. There is filtered UV rays coming through.
I need me some UV.
A spot. What is the dug-in window? What kind of window would you call that?
Basement window?
A basement window. You guys can envision a basement window, right? I don't have to explain it to you.
Yeah, it's the kind where, like, you feel like you're trapped and you're trying to get out and scream, but no one can hear you, and there's these iron bars and they prevent you from breaking the glass.
Are you talking about jail?
No, your basement.
I'll see you later.
Oh,
okay.
All right, and that was
Vishan, sponsored by Vishan.
Sponsored by Vishan. Let's give him a round of applause.
Who's next?
Who's next?
Do we go outside?
Do we go outside? We do not.
Okay.
So this was the Nice Guys Radio Podcast. Remember, we are not mean. We are nice. And we'll see you in the next one for a proper length episode.
Hopefully.
All right.
Not mean.
It's been a day.
Adios.
Muchachos.
Muchachos. No se llama amor. Diego, yo no te la noche.